Sports. It's in the game.
Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Greg Zuerlein's got it teed up, and off we go from Arlington. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Brady now to throw. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And for a second straight play, that Cowboy defense gets him to the ground behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Now Brady on the bootleg, steps away. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 43. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see. Yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
C.D. Lamb.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And he will have a Cowboys first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. Throw left side complete. That's Elliott. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Prescott with a throw caught by Lamb. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 12 yards there and a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Prescott yet again. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete. CeeDee Lamb is intended target. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott going to throw deep for the end zone. And that'll be incomplete. Prescott took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And they're going to stop him short of the 1st down as he's tackled at about the 21. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein.
Cowboy field goal. A 38-yard attempt.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And it's complete. They're going to get the first. And they're able to pick up the first and keep possession. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. The opportunity was there for them to take the lead with a field goal and get 3. Instead, they want a little more.
Sometimes being a little greedy is not a bad thing, right? I mean, don't just take what they're going to give you or what's evident. Go try and get more. And yes, there's a little bit of a risk to it, but boy, they made it pay off in a big way.
Now left side on the swing pass. And the Cowboys are going to be looking at 1st and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys.
Makes the score, Cowboys 7, Buccaneers nothing. Greg Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And makes it across the 20 as these guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. 10.
3-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. After 1-7-0, Audie Sports.
No.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. Call it a gain of 4, but not enough. The punt team going to need to be summoned here on fourth down.
Fourth down.
Here's Bradley Pinion now.
Since you're on fourth down, you don't have to. You can push time out and change the play.
But how about this, a fake? And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And that will force a turnover on downs. Prescott on first down. He finds his target. It's Schultz.
Why you didn't punt it?
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve.
If you'd have punted it out, I had a lot longer way to go.
Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Here's 2nd and 5 now from the 22. They'll run with Elliott. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs 17. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And he'll go underneath here to Elliott. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Jordan Whitehead there defensively.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0.
Makes the score Cowboys 14. Buccaneers nothing. Rick Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a 1st down now. A run there on 1st down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it 2nd and 5.
The tackle made by Jalen Smith. It's a gain of 5.
2 minutes to play, 1st half. It's 14-0.
24-yard line.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. Out to his left. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
A nice run there by Jones on first down as he'll wind up getting about 5, so 2nd and 5 coming up. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5.
At the 35-yard line.
Off the bootleg, Brady. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield, get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
This defense is really fooling around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Here's Bradley Pinion now. On, we think, to punt, though he's faked it earlier, but he was unsuccessful. And look at this, another fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Prescott from the gun. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. Cooper was the intended target, and it's 2nd down. So incomplete on 1st. Let's see what 2nd down has in store. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And this is caught. It's Cooper. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. It'll be a gain of 24 on the play. And it'll move the chains. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field.
3-yard attempt.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it.
Wow.
And this one will not work out. It is incomplete. And that'll do it for the end of the 2nd quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3.
For Tampa Bay.
The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter 3. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Cowboys take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Trying for Cooper again. This time he finds him. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. Going to take a shot for Gallup. He's got a man complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A big gain of 39 on 3rd.
2-yard line.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Brings up 2nd.
They go to Elliott again. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on 3rd down.
By Shaq Barrett.
Well, Prescott stripped. And it's picked up by the Buccaneers. There he goes, left side, the 20, 10, 5, And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the one-yard line.
I think what we just saw there with that fumble return is the increased emphasis on taking the ball away from another team. And no one wants to just fall on the football anymore, do they? They want to take it and try and score themselves.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. A one-yard touchdown pass. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And this fake extra point attempt failed big time. Not only did they not get it, they went backwards.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and oh, he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward is just not there.
So risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
Prescott looks to throw on first. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Ndamukong Suh with a sack. We've seen that a ton since he entered the league in 2010. Now a pass hauled in downfield. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
38-yard line.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Here's a quick throw by Dak, complete out wide. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. They show run with three tight ends here on first down.
13-yard line.
Now Elliott. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
And Ndamukong Suh on the stop.
Again, it's Elliott. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
I'll get
no gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
No gain on the play. Brings up third down and seven.
Throwing, Prescott. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And they'll rally and stop him short of the first down at about the 6. 5 yards, not enough. And it'll be fourth down. Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein.
Cowboy field goal. A 23-yard.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. That catch good for only a couple. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with
going for Evans, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see plays unfold and make their own plays, but you also have to have good feel as well because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold, feel what's going on, and then get to the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and the lead is up to 15 now.
Kickoff for Dallas.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Bucs take over first and 10.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, you know, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Forward here on second and 14. To throw is Brady. To Evans on the slant.
Brady's
the reception good for seven. It's third down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
The Bucs on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 7. He's got Evans. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Brady to Evans that time. First down, Tampa.
Buccaneers.
Now Brady. There's Evans again. Complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Again, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he'll be corralled out across midfield, down to the 45. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Jones, and he's going to be met at about the 43. Trayvon Diggs getting the tackle. He has just been completely taken out of this game. We're in the fourth quarter. He's single digits in the rushing department.
And I know we look at him because the numbers do go to his production, but how about the guys blocking for him? They don't just have his number as a ball carrier. They've got the number of the offensive line and the other guys because they're getting to him before he can get started.
It's a first down on a gain of 10. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now Brady on the bootleg. And Brady, the tight end's got it. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
At the 33-yard line.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain. Stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Brady. His throw caught right around the 6. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
Tampa Bay.
He got 29 yards that time. It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. They'll try to run it in with Jones. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. From the 2 now, second and goal. They'll try again with Jones. And this time he is in. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bucs are able to cut in now to that deficit.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 40. Now Prescott. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. picked up by Jordan Whitehead, and he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
Why are you celebrating?
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Rolling to his left. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
And that's why you do all the drills that you do from the quarterback position, because you're not going to just throw to your strength. The right-handed quarterback naturally will want to move to the right side to throw the football. But sometimes you've got to go left, and that's exactly what happened on that play. Forced to his left, still able to accurately throw it downfield for a completion.
They lost four there, and it's third down.
But plays like that, Charles, no doubt, they're just going to continue to fuel this crowd.
And this defense is already playing well, but it also feeds on the energy of that crowd that you're talking about, and that takes them up to another level. Right now, they're playing really loose. They've got the lead, and what a nice stop they just made there behind the line of scrimmage.
They stop them for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and he passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw, and it's incomplete. Still throwing to the very end. But now this game is over.
Okay.
So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And I think you'd have to label this an upset. Yes, they were at home, but still an upset. They got the job done.
Yeah, even being at home was not enough for people to think they were going to pull this one off. But give them credit for playing not just a smart football game, but one where they were going to be physical about the whole thing. They put up their fists and said, let's fight, and showed their crowd that they were into this one.
And then that's the thing, the crowd responded. They were really good in this game.
Yeah, they were not going to be pushed around. They were not going to be intimidated. They refused to back down and came away with a victory.
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.
Have you combed your hair? Have you combed your hair? When I asked the question, what should you do, baby? Huh?
Head to toe designer drip, little bit. Let me fill myself a little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big, get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Come pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drill, little bit. Let me fill myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe, designer. Drill, little bit. Let me fill myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me fill myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me fill myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.